All right, good afternoon, ladies and gents, all those people who will bother to watch this video. This is the first episode of The Drib, which is just basically a show where we're going to talk dribble about sport. We'll just basically go through a lot of the key codes and some of the things that are happening in sport over the week and the weeks coming up. On the panel, I have myself, Damon, Chris, Jordan and Rory. These are some of the mainstays, but we'll be getting a few guests in for the future episodes along the way. So let's start with the NRL boys. So the week gone, who was good, who was bad? Fatman?
Good, obviously, Brisbane Cows, easy standout game of the round. They'll be there at the end of the year when the whips are cracking. Bad, I also thought Sharks were good and the Dogs were good as well, but I think Brisbane Cow was still a little bit a level
above. It's a good brand of footy they're playing
at the moment. It's good footy all around at the moment.
Like when you look at the grand final last year, which is a cracker game, and also the semi, which is also a cracker game. So the last three games they played.
160 minutes decided by field goal.
Yeah.
Crazy. And I think bad last week were Raiders letting the Titans back in that game. Frank Paul Norsala, Fair Dinkum, go to the mirror, have a hard look at yourself. Don't turn up the train Monday and Tuesday, you'll be cutting laps all day. You'll be on your ass, mate. That was disgraceful.
And you'd be filthy, wouldn't you? Sticky wouldn't be giving
him up. And I think the Roosters, but the Roosters have got excuses.
You wouldn't be invited to cruises on the roof at Canberra, that's for sure.
Rory, any anything to add there, mate?
Oh, mate.
Who'd you like?
I think I like the MILF for Dally M.
Yeah, I got him at seven on Puntaa. Cheers, yeah, across.
He's a special. And Valentine Holmes, mate. Three bomb tries.
Benny Barb looks like he's finding his feet again. Looks like he's enjoying his footy. It's a good try scored.
No, he's got people already perking up last few weeks. Yeah. 0-12 belly in form. He's not there yet.
You got to swerve around when he got that try. To swerve around Munster. That was pretty impressive.
He's got his pace back.
Yeah, absolutely. Kenny, anything to add to that?
No, I just reckon the Sharkies, good things for top four, looking good. Valentine's back chiming in, even though he's bombing tries, but we'll cop that. He's got the ball in the hand, so we're looking good.
He's good.
He's bloody good.
Now. Let's have a quick look at the week ahead. So, first game, obviously, is the Broncos-Titans, well, aside from last night's game, but Broncos all around, boys, you can't see the Titans causing too much trouble.
I'm down the sea bus for no reason, Bronx, I think. Sorry, Titans just called off.
Bait the two.
Storm Knights.
Same again.
Storm.
Yeah, drumming. The Knights are in a lot of Barney rubble. Tigers,
Sharks.
Sharks.
I think special at the line, man.
Three and a half. It's only a try.
Yeah, exactly right.
I reckon we'll keep them to zero again.
Yeah.
Like last week. Struggle to score tries against Parra.
I don't know. The Tigers are taking points on.
How'd they go last week? You have to put on points.
Yeah.
Time again this week, mate. It'll be Gout. The steel in defence.
He'll go down with a hammy.
G-tro.
I love how he comes out and says, this is my last year of Origin. Well, you haven't even made the team yet. He will, though.
He'll think he's released two penalties, I reckon. I'll take
some. He's played five club games in 2 years.
Oh, it's ridiculous.
You're on big bucks, too.
Yeah,
no. All right, so we've got Cowboys, Dragons.
Boys.
Cows. They'll be reeling after last week.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, it's fair. I mean, Dragons, they haven't gone too bad. They had a shocking round one, and then they've come all right.
Very lucky last week.
Yeah,
and against the Rabbits, it was just wet weather.
5 day turnaround.
Yeah,
very lucky wins. They'll be back down to earth this week.
Burgess was out. How much has Burgess lift the Rabbits?
Yeah. He's more than a prop, mate. He's a hard one.
That was a brain snap. Okay, let's move on to AFL now. So the first round's down. I'm not going to be able to contribute too much to this, to be honest, but who was good? Who impressed? Who did you like?
The obvious ones, like Dogs are really impressive against Freo.
Yeah, the Dogs.
You can also say Geelong were good against Hawthorn. I'm going to get left field here. I think Carlton really impressed me against Tigers. Tigers are ordinary, very piss poor. But for a team that their list is pretty ordinary, I reckon they really showed a bit of desire and a bit of pressure. And I'll surprise a lot of teams this year. Carlton for me, Brennan Bolton's doing some sensational things down there.
Thoughts? Have you seen how a lot of the first grade coach AFL coaches have stemmed off Hawks? What's his name?
Coach Alistair Clarkson,
assistants, and then even under them as assistants, it's amazing.
It's phenomenal.
And what do you think about the number one draft pick being the best since
who they say?
Is that a big call early?
I'll tell you what, mate, he was pretty bloody
good. He was chirping too.
Yeah, chirping at Jack, but Jack would have probably given it two.
Cripps was good too.
Yeah, mate, I reckon they'll surprise a lot of teams. I reckon they'll win at least 6-7 games. Well, they've got Essendon twice, so you can bank those two. But yeah, Carlton really impressed me actually. The Tigers didn't do themselves any favours. But,
and disappointment?
Disappointment, definitely Freo. I reckon the way the game's going with the interchange and.
They don't score points.
Exactly, mate. And the Dogs just tore them apart.
But did you notice how high scoring all the games were?
Yeah.
And they don't score points?
38 points.
Yeah, man. Yeah, it's
a disgrace. 9-8. I think the way the game's going, it's just going away from the Dockers. I think Big Ross better rejig his list because I don't think they'll be finished top four this year. They make the final because they win all the games at home, but I don't think they'll be finishing top four. That's for sure.
All right, so let's look at the week ahead. Collingwood versus Richmond. Who's your pick there, mate?
Well, big Tigers, man, but I reckon the Pies will win, unfortunately. Fingers crossed they don't, but, you know, sneaky suspicion. The market's got that wrong. I think Richmond should be outsiders. All right. Too many injuries.
Fatman?
I'm hoping Richmond, mate. As long as the ball doesn't go over that white line too much, I'm thinking Richmond.
Rory, any thoughts on just pass?
I'll take the Pies. Me mate Joshy Smith drafted there, mate. I'm a big Pies man this year. So.
Oh, yeah? Oh,
Smithy. Yeah.
Is he good?
Alright, Adelaide Crows.
Oh, I'm hoping the Crows.
So the Derby versus Port Adelaide.
Yeah, mate.
Yeah, Crows are famous.
This is set up for the big text then, I reckon.
Yeah, Texy. Yeah,
text for the showdown medal, kick a bag, and Crows to get the line.
What's happened to their new bets? They don't want him anymore.
No, they want him.
Oh, but they're not playing him up the front or something?
I think they're trying to play him up winger.
Isn't he good at the front, though? He gets some goals, man.
You would have thought so.
Yeah, small forwards. Why do they want these big forwards at the front now who can't get goals?
Well, Jenkins kicked five last week. I think Tex man will kick a bag. Yeah. Port are good, but everyone is raving. I think it's over. I think Adelaide will win, but very, very ripper. I'm surprised it's a midday on a Saturday. It should be a Saturday night special.
Alrighty.
Derby's good.
Bombers versus the Demons.
Oh, Deeds, I reckon, but
don't even ask me about the
rubbish game. Yeah.
Moving on.
The buyer.
Lions versus North Melbourne.
North.
Yeah, I reckon.
Lions lost another midfielder this week.
Lions weren't too bad, though, even though they got a bit of a drum last week.
Yeah, I'd kick 100 points against West Coast. Yeah, it's not bad, but I think North will be winning.
Even at home, yeah, fair enough.
Yeah, well, Gatton's not exactly a fortress.
Dockers versus Gold Coast Suns.
Dockers to bounce back, mate. Dockers to bounce back. Suns.
I reckon Suns. Anyway.
Yeah. What's the line there?
I reckon they'll go
right. If it's under 40, you'd take Suns, I reckon, for sure. At the line, obviously.
They've moved Benoit for a number of reasons. Can't handle it in the Sunset Strip.
Yeah, well, and Dixon as well, mate. You can draw your own line to a conclusion there. Excuse the pun.
The Lions 29.5.
Ooh, yeah. I don't think Freo will be smashing them anyway.
No, it's Kangas. Oh, no. We're talking Freo about Sunset. Yeah.
Okay, St Kilda.
Dogs.
Bulldogs.
Ruby's 300th, but Doggies.
Saints put up a bit of fight last week, but Doggies look good.
Doggies at Etihad, mate. It's like the fortress. It's like playing Logan Brothers at Civic Park.
They got a fence.
You don't beat them there.
We're talking Cameron Smith, Corey Parker.
It's a fortress, Civic Park.
Civic. I was going to say with the Dogs, I was going to say there. Doesn't matter. I'll come back to me.
GWS versus Geelong.
Cats.
Geelong. Stevie J to play well, but Geelong to win.
Stevie J to try and kick them all.
Yeah, well, he'll probably kick a few against Geelong. He'll be fired up. He'll do something good anyway. Yeah.
All right, Hawthorn Hawks, West Coast Eagles.
Best bet of the weekend, West Coast minus 5.5. I think the line is will beat Hawthorn. Injury depleted. Will bounce back, but I don't think they'll be West Coast. They'll turn the grand final result around, I think. That's my best for the weekend.
Yeah, that's good enough for me.
All right, last game, Carlton versus Sydney Swans.
Swans.
Very impressive last week. They'll dispatch of Carlton, but as I said, they have improved, so I wouldn't be expecting too much of a drubbing there. The buddy man to kick a few.
All right, so let's move on to a bit of EPL real quickly. So pretty exciting year this year, because as we all know, Leicester have come from absolutely nowhere and they're sitting at the top of the table, 5 points clear, with the Hotspurs second behind them. So do you think the Hotspurs can mount a challenge, or do you think Leicester will hold on?
Don't miss the whole one.
You look at this weekend's pivotal. You got Leicester. They're playing a tricky game against Southampton. Southampton not too bad, and they're playing in pretty decent form. But it is King Power Stadium. But Tottenham have Liverpool at Anfield. So Liverpool have been hit striking a bit of form of late. So if Tottenham can't get any points back this week against Leicester, you'd say it's done and dusted.
Yeah, sure.
Tottenham still got to play. I think that Man U, Chelsea, and they're going to play Stoke away, which is a bit of City Park
situation. Banks got to get his hand off it.
Oh, mate. Buy
surely get rid of it.
Yeah, buy someone.
His time's up.
It's a true culture of failure.
Oh, mate.
They've got a fair few good players.
Yeah, they do.
It's a culture.
That's my head in. As you
can do. It just capitulates. But I think Leicester will hold on. They've still got a couple of tough games, but if there's no points, they could easily both draw, and if that's good enough for Leicester, I reckon.
Their draw's not that bad, I don't think.
I looked at it today. I think they've got to play West Ham, which, mate, they're harder to beat than a frozen egg at the moment. if they can get away with not losing any points this week, it could be all over, I think. So, see how we go.
All right, cool. All right, let's move on. Horse racing. So tomorrow we've got the Doncaster. Winks, will he get up?
I think so. It's a class horse. Like, it's beaten most of that field already, like, a few times. It's got a wide barrier, but if Huey can get in, I don't even think if it has a bit of a tire run, I think it'll still be too good.
Yeah.
Wallace said it's track work. He might just say it's anyway, but it's the track work rides, and that said it's the best work the horse has ever done. And it's only halfway through its racing career. Like, it's still got, you know what I mean, the number of races done. The main aim's the Queen Elizabeth next week. I'm hoping. I didn't even want to run the Doncaster because I backed it to the Queen Elizabeth. But But I'm hoping.
Don't tell Kate or what?
Ben, don't tell Kate. Oh, shit, she might watch this. I didn't know.
We'll edit it out.
We won't.
Yeah, I don't know if she's going to get done. This will be the race. Handicap conditions. 1.5 kilo swing back to Kermadec. 1.5 lengths off last time, so you can sort of bring it back to the field there. Kermadec's third up. Ran the fastest last 600 in the George Ryder. I just think.
I don't think the weight's that much big though. Big, it's like something
for a mare though, carrying a bit heavier.
Mare and four mace, it's just.
Yeah. Well, I'm not going to jump into.
I'm not going to jump into it tomorrow either. But I think
my top three would be Winks, Escadelia, and Kermadec for the top three. In which order, I don't really know, but I'll definitely be having a little save on Kermadec with all those stats I just reeled off.
Got your homework, mate.
Kermadec's on a bad point.
Yeah, I think Tony Luce will run, they're saying it's going to go faster out in front, which might split him up a bit. So, see how we go for Escadilli to run home hard.
All right, boys. Well, more exciting news coming up next week because we've got the Masters starting.
Everyone's pretty pumped. Best event in the world. For sure.
Yep. Thoughts? Who do you think is going to win? Who's in form? Who are your picks? What are you liking? Or who are you liking, I should say?
I am liking top three. I'm going Jason Day. He's been in pretty good form. Bubba Watson, just because he knows the track. I think he's won there twice previously. And my special, because he's a favourite of mine, is the Big E's.
What's he paying?
He's paying 150s or something, but he just loves it when he's got the iron and he's just shaking that ass, mate. It's so good. It's just so good. Like, you can't go past
him. Yeah. I think my top three, Jason Day, putting well, need to do that, definitely. Boat is its finest. Best product definitely to come out of Boat Desert.
Is there anything else?
Yeah. The Mount Lindsay Highway taking it out. Dustin Johnson, he's a big game player. He hasn't won a major yet, but I reckon he's definitely overdue. You can see how he's going at the Houston Open. He's looming. He's one behind.
Oh, Wayne Gretzky's daughter.
Yeah,
he's winning even if he doesn't.
Yeah, exactly.
Even if he doesn't win, mate.
Yeah, he just goes home to every night to win. I think he'll be up there. $26. I got him at this morning. So I have a crack and. My roughie for the thing, get on boys, Brandon Grace at 61.
South Africa.
Putts well. The only reason he's such a big price is he's missed the cut the last 2 years, but if you look at his majors last year, he finished two top fives. He putts well, solid golf at 61, so you can do a lot worse than that.
What's
for
your
sure.
rules?
Mate, I'd reckon Smokey to keep an eye on, Sergio Garcia.
Oh, the Spaniard. I was hoping Miguel's in there, putting a big kiss.
Just for no reason, just keep an eye on him.
He could win a game of bowls against a blind person, mate. He's a non-winner.
He's a non. His putting's awful. What are you talking about?
Oh, right. Right.
Yeah,
is he in the mix?
Yeah, he'd be up there.
He's gone close.
McElroy.
His best year was that year he choked Greg Norman style. Should have won it that year. I don't think he's playing well enough, to be honest.
And we've also got a punter bet golf game coming up. Canny vs. Plugger. 18 shot. Head start for Plugger. You reckon you'll get him, mate?
No, I reckon I'll turn that around the first nine.
That'll be cool. Another side bet on that one, Plugger. All right, moving on. So now I'm just going to go into a few little fun and trivial kind of questions. So start with coach sackings. Any coaches you think might get sacked this year from any code? Thoughts?
I think league, Tigers, everyone's talking them up, but I just still think there's a bit of tension there with Taylor and Farrah. And if Farrah keeps playing and pushes, I reckon they'll start losing games and then Taylor will be under the pump. And in the AFL, probably no one, as Cammy said, but I just don't see how Buckley can keep going there if he's not winning games. He missed the eight last year. If he misses the eight again this year, like surely it's gone.
I don't think Collingwood have got too big a list of us not winning games. I think they win tonight.
You reckon they'll win a couple?
Yeah.
You reckon they'll make the eight though?
It depends. Yeah, well, Swanee's out's massive.
Yeah, he's out for the whole year.
I think Cloak's playing like a bloody ballerina. I think he's cooked. He'll be gone at the end of the year, but I don't think any coach will be sacked. I think they'll be given their chance.
You and McFadden hate, mate.
Yeah, I reckon they're a good chance of slipping up against the Roosters this weekend, and then I reckon
if they slip,
big strike.
Well, if they slip up against the Roosters,
they're expected, like before the season started, they were expected to be, you know, top four, really. Yeah.
12-6 down against the Knights. I thought, here we go. That could be curtains. They turned it on.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, I think I reckon Trent Barrett might be in trouble if if the Sea Eagles can't sort of put a few wins together.
Oh, yeah, stick with him.
Yeah.
He doesn't have the experience.
That's why they
would
just
wrap
him up.
Well, yeah, Vossie was saying last night they'd have to get him out in the paddock soon when Coruscant went down injured. Well, they got all the halves of bloody
guys on the road. Pack anyway, Barrett. Probably a better coach and player. Christ.
Another one, Michael Foley from the Force. He's got a worse record than bloody Richard Graham, but everyone loves him. I don't know how.
They'll get drubbed again today. 20 point start.
They've been rubbish the last two games. Pumped.
All right, moving on. We've got a little segment called Biggest Tezza of the Week. So Tezza is in, for those of you who don't know, is a tryhard. Biggest Tezza of the Week, let's start with Rory. I think you've got a pretty good one.
Chad the Dad Townsend. Oh, mate, he was on the end of a bloody Valentine Holmes breakaway. Scored the runaway try, got up and just...
Did a dab.
Can't do the dab.
White man can't
doubt.
Dab's awful.
For me, it was pretty much the whole Socceroos team, after thinking they're pretty shit hot because they drummed Jordan 5-1. They're still off the pace. They're still off. I mean, they're improving as a team, but I mean, yeah, hopefully they'll qualify for the World Cup, but I mean, the way they got to qualify, the route they got to go through is a lot easier than
Matilda's probably got to beat Jordan 7-1. They're better than the old Socceroos, let's be honest. They're 5 in the world.
Kenny?
Chris Gale for sure. We all love Gailey, and we don't mind a third person chat, but if you're saying an interview and you refer to yourself four times in one sentence, you kid yourself. Do yourself a favour, punters. Go and have a look at Chris Gale's interview before the T20 semi-final. Absolute cracker.
Anything to add there, Fatman?
Nah, I don't really have one this week, but I'll give a small mention to Robbo from Fox. Go pump a few more darts, mate. I'll join you.
So quickly wrapping up, we've got a legend of the week. So looking at our past legend of sport, we're going to go with Johan Cruyff. He sadly passed away after pumping a few too many darts. Did not mind the old cancer stick. But what a player, what a legacy he's left behind. Won 3 Ballon d'Or awards. He won 9 titles in the Dutch league, 3 European Cups. Went to Barca, won the Spanish league. Runners up, and then he fell one short in the World Cup in 74, lost to West Germany. Was a master of total football, has a football move named after him, the Cruyff Turn, and they're even thinking about naming the Barcelona Stadium after him, so obviously...
That's not going to happen.
Well, there's talk of it.
That's not going to happen.
Well, even if it doesn't, it's still pretty good.
That's the biggest dribble that's been spit today. That's not happening.
They're saying the Amsterdam Arena will probably be renamed after him as well, so...
Yeah, well, that's more...
That's probably more likely, yeah, but I mean, still, a good player.
The new camp turns,
No.
Yeah, it'll be messy before it's crowed.
Yeah, that's probably true. And last, closing up the first drib of the is the best pun bet of the week gone by. This is an absolute cracker. It was done by Danny Brooks, Moosey Punts. He bet one of the punter co-founders, Heaney, that the Cowboys Broncos game would be decided by a drop goal. Sending it, was it 7-1 odds?
6-1.
6-1, and I was like, Heaney, take that all day. Like, that's Dan, never going to happen.
Dan, you got stitched, mate. You could have got 50, I reckon. Old Fox Cap got over that.
Good call, bud. Like, no,
that's a big well, well done.
Heaney's like, he's not well done. Stitched me up. He's almost in tears paying that bet out.
Oh, so, mate, he should be thinking he's like, he stars. He's going to be taken to the Queens.
Don't get a tweet in, too.
Any tezzas of the week?
Yeah. Any questions you got for next week?
Yeah, that's the first episode. It's a bit of a train wreck, but we'll try and improve as we go along the journey. Cheers.